Hello friends, so today I'm going to explain you about the Linux user administration part. So in this video I will cover how to create user, how to delete user, how to assign a password, like if you want to modify the user, then how you can do. Okay, so before go to practical, so let me explain little bit theory. I just give the overview. So basically, in a Linux there are three types of account: root account, system account, and user account. So root, when we are talking about the root account, it means super user. So super user have full control. Super user can run any command. When we are talking about the system account, means system account are those needed for the operation or system specified commands like SSHD, like it's a related to operation and system specified. When we are talking about the user account, it means local account. We are talking about the local account. It means user account means we have to go to log into the server and we have to create manually. So that is a local account, and that local account have the limited privilege. So I will explain you how to create local account. So I will show you. So in user and group files, user and group that few files are there. So let me explain there. So /etc/password. So it's a /etc/password. It's a holding the user information like UID, GID, like it's a user related information. So and this is the interview question also, like interviewer they will ask what is what content a holding the /etc/password. So I will upload now one video and I will explain each and every section about the /etc/password. And /etc/shadow, it's holding the user password related information, like when we are going to password, when password going to expire, so last when change, this kind of information. /etc/group, it's holding the group information. And /gshadow, it's holding the contents secure group account information. So like these are the command: user add, if you want to create, you use the user add command. If you want to modify, you can use user mode. User delete, the deleting the user, same like that for group: group add, group mode, group delete. So when you're using the user add command, these are the options. Like if you want to, you can use this option: -c -e -m -r. So I will explain you in a practically what is the meaning of -m -s. So these are the user mode. So here I can explain about the -g and -caps g. So this also interview question: what is the difference between a small g and caps g in user mode command? So when we are talking about a small g, you're going to assign primary group particular user, and when we are talking about the caps g, then you are going to assign secondary group particular user. If you want to lock the user, you can use -l user mode -l. If you want to unlock, you can use -u command, then user will be unlocked. Same way, user del, you have to use user del, and user del -f means you wants to forcefully, if you wants to forcefully delete, you then use -f. If you wants to user home directory also wants to delete, then you use -r. Okay, so this is a password. So let me first go to the server and I will explain you practically. So this is my server. I'm going to create the user. User add -u means UID. I'm going to assign UID. -g GID. -c. So, -c means comment. So in the comment section, basically we are giving why we are creating account. So this is I'm going to give admin account. Admin account. So you have to give in a double quote that comment. Then hyphen D. So like you have to give the user home directory path. So I'm going to give here. So let me John. So you hyphen hyphen home. So you had slash sorry slash home and slash John. John is a user. John is a user. So and this is the path. So user home directory. If you not give, then automatically also it will go to the home. Why it will go to the home? That I will show you. And then you have to assign which cell. So I'm going to assign bin bash. And then finally you have to give here username. So you can see your user is created successfully because you're not getting any error. If you want to check your user is created or not, you can use id command and then you can see it's showing hyphen dead, uid, gid, everything is showing here. Okay, so when you're creating a first time your user, you know the user account means you know you automatically by default log. So I will show you passwd hyphen hyphen status and then your username. Sorry, you have to sorry my mistake, I given this space. So you can see here it's showing log, right? So I created user, so I'm going to assign password for user. So assign the password, then you have to use this command pass WD and then username. So what is the username? John. So it's asking of it's telling new password. So I'm going to assign new password here and confirm the password and hit enter. So password assigned successfully. If you check now, you can see your account user account is not locked there. Okay. So like you know, now let me log in. First, let me log in to the server with this new user. Then I will show you. So when you first time log into the server with a new account, it will take some time because usually going to create inside home directory some basic file. Okay, so now let me give the password here. Yeah, my. So I have to log in with the new user. If you want to switch sudo, I think it will not work. See, it's saying it's not added sudo because I already told you, right? When you're creating a, your local user, it's a limited privilege. So if you want to, you know, give the sudo access, then you go and assign secondary group, that secondary root secondary group id yeah. So you go and assign root secondary group like root group, that is a build group. So I'm going to use that user mode command here. User mode hyphen and here in this John user, I'm going to assign secondary group. So what option I have to use? Hyphen caps G and then will John. If you see, if you can check now, it's showing, see? Now what you do? Log in again, take duplicate session. Okay, so add into this session because this is not needed now. Okay, so meanwhile I will show you, I told you right, if you're not giving a slash this one home, the automatically it will take a slash inside the home directory, right? Why? Because you know when you're creating a user, so that system is you know following this file. This file and as per this file instruction, assigning the parameter to user. slash etc default user head. If you go here, you can see it's showing home slash home by default, which cell, this cell, and the scale it, this file is going to create the user, you know, inside the user home directory, some basic file like. So this is the by default parameter. So let me log into the server now. If you now try to sudo, switch to sudo, so you can see you are able to switch root account, you know. Okay, so this is a way, like, you know, you can create a local account and means, you know, like and assign the password. If you want to check user, you know, like some basic information like when, what is the, when last time password change, like so, and the password going to expire when, so then you can use this command. Sorry. Says hyphen L. L means list, and then your user. See, it's saying last password change 24th, so today, and password expire even it's set is never, never. So it's showing all the information here, you know. Okay, so now I will tell you one more thing. So this is the file, you know, when we are creating a user, it's taking some information from here, like UID kind of things. Slash etc login dot dev. Yeah. So this is a file. So you, when you're creating a user, so they, you know, it's taking some information from the here, like a UMask kind of things, you know. So if you want to learn, you know, what are things inside this file, you go and this file and check, then you can understand. Okay, so let me show that user mode command. I already show you how to assign the, you know, secondary group, you know. Suppose now, if you want to delete this user, let me go to the first slash home. We created the user, right? So inside home, it's showing John, this thing. Suppose if you want to delete the user, so let me show you. User, you have to use user tell command. User tell, sorry, my mistake. User tell, and then your username. So I'm going to delete this test one. Okay, so it's telling, you know, like group test is the primary group, the another user, and it's not removing. Okay, fine. Okay, no problem. So okay, let me show you one more thing here first. So when we are creating a user, right? So you're giving manually these things, user add, and you like UID, GID, you're giving manually, right? So if you want to, then you can give the manually. If you don't want, then you can go and create directly. I will show you that one. Sorry. My keyboard is not working. User dev, and then you give some name here, username. So I'm giving it user six, test six. So user tell, not user add. I'm going to create user, right? So I created user. If you check, you can see its home directory came here, right? By default, because it's reading which file? Slash etc default of default slash user add. So now let me delete the user. Now user. Delete and test six. So I deleted the user. So if you use this command, user del and test, you know, it will remove the user, but it will not remove the user home directory. Let me see. It's still, you know, test six is still showing. So if you want to delete user home directory, then you should have to use hyphen R. Fine. it's telling user John is a currently use the process 18161. Why? Because I already opened one session here by John. See, so you have to log out from here first, then it will work. Yeah, see, so successfully user del means user deleted. So let me show you. Now you can see. So John home directory is not available here. So it hyphen R means if you want to delete user home directory, then you can use hyphen R. So I hope you like this video, and please subscribe my channel so you will get the more notification with updated videos. And thanks for your